As of late, there has been a fair amount of discussion regarding democratic socialism. The candidacy of Senator Bernie Sanders, who is a self-described socialist, offered the opportunity to take a look. The obvious place to start is with the Scandinavian countries, and a reasonable organization to reference would be the Conservative Heritage Foundation. In addition, we'll look at some United Nations statistics. The Heritage Foundation produces a report showing the economic freedom of 178 countries. The United States comes in 11th out of that 178. Let's take a look how the three Scandinavian countries do. Denmark comes in number 12, one behind the United States. Sweden is in at 26, and Norway, while finishing only 32, is still in the top 18%. Two other countries, Finland and Iceland, are often considered part of this group. So how did they do? Iceland came in at a more than respectable 20, and Finland was 24. So based on Heritage Foundation analysis, we can see that the five Scandinavian countries, while not performing so well as the United States, all scored in the top 18% of countries in the study. Pretty impressive. They are doing well economically, but are they happy?
According to the United Nations Sustainable Development Solutions Network's World Happiness Report, these are the 25 happiest countries in the world.
15. United States.
The world's largest economy by nominal and real GDP, the U.S. is a major technological and political force. Famous for its affluence, liberal principles, and consumerism, the U.S. offers citizens the ability to obtain the American dream.
8. Sweden.
Apart from numerous economic and social privileges, such as the world's 8th highest per capita income, top quality of life, excellent health and educational system, protection of civil liberties, etc., Sweden can offer its inhabitants clean environment as well as astonishing cities packed with historic sites and unique architecture.
6. Finland.
Similarly to its neighbor Sweden, Finland is also a top performer in numerous metrics of national performance, including economic competitiveness, civil liberties, quality of life, human development, etc. In 2010, Newsweek chose Finland as the best country in the world.
4. Norway.
Considered one of the most developed democracies and the states of justice in the world, Norway regularly ranks among the best countries to live in. With the 4th highest per capita income in the world, this country is also noticeable for its astonishing natural landmarks, well-preserved wildlife, and clean environment.
3. Denmark.
Denmark slipped from number 1 to the 3rd spot this year, but the country's overall well-being is still very high. World's highest social mobility, an outstanding level of income equality, prosperity, civil liberty, and one of the world's highest per capita incomes are just some of the reasons why the Danes are so happy about living in their country.
2. Iceland.
Another Nordic country boasting incredible natural beauties and top quality of life, Iceland is particularly famous for its safeness. For many consecutive years, this isolated northern European country has been rated the most peaceful country in the world according to the Global Peace Index. Combined with their enormous well-being, these Icelanders seem destined for happiness.
The report from the United Nations is damned impressive. The Scandinavian countries take 5 of the top 8 spots. All 5 are in the top 5% in happiness, and all 5 did better than the United States. These people are just flat out happy. So between the two reports, one from Heritage, the other from the United Nations, what did we learn? I think we learned that these democratic socialists in Scandinavia have both economic freedom and are seriously happy. It is pretty clear that they will not be adding to our immigration woes. The population figures, however, demonstrate a sharp contrast that requires more research. But in any event, it is pretty clear that democratic socialism should not be dismissed out of hand. We'll be right back.